We have had excellent support from the diplomatic community here in Geneva over the past 8 years when Dr. Tuwei was the Secretary General. Of course, I'm part of the team as well. And we really appreciate your confidence and your support and cooperation. But on a personal level, I was encouraged by many of you during my campaign for the post of ITU Secretary General. It was a really very memorable period for me. To tell you a secret, your support is critical for my success. That when Chinese government talked about my candidate and asked the Chinese mission in Geneva to get some kind of feedback from you, and the Chinese ambassador told me over the last 2 years, they always get very good support, very good comments from all of you, that you know that Chinese government seems to be very confident that if we have clear support from Geneva diplomat family, that my chance to be elected will be very, very high. So that I take this opportunity to thank all of you for your encouragement, for your confidence to me and to China to support my candidate as Secretary General over last 2 years of campaign period. Indeed, your encouragement and support were most gratifying, and I'm looking forward to working closely with you over the next 4 years. People talk to me 4 years or 8 years. I said it's better to say 4 years at this moment. This morning, we planned about a short meeting, about 1 hour. So I planned to have such arrangement that I give first my opening remarks. Then my colleagues will each give you very short remarks. And then I will provide very short briefings on the result of PP 14, and then we show you some small video to give you idea what PP 14 look like, and finally the video on the ITU's 150th anniversary celebration information. And in the end, I hope you know we will have time before 11:30 some time for you to, if you wish, to pick the floor to say a few words. And then after 11:30, we prepare a very cold drink. We don't call it a cocktail, because he corrected me, cocktail with alcohol, and without alcohol. So we have some coffee or tea and a soft drink outside of a purple room. So we would like to have this opportunity to allow you, all are my colleagues, all have chance to talk to you, to have some kind of chat. So this is something we arranged for this 1 hour session. As you know, that during my campaign, I had a lot of interviews. In one of the interviews, the journalist asked me to use three words to characterize myself. So I used the three words: vision, action, and harmony. I was very pleased. I published this interview very late at the beginning of October. Then our Excellency Ambassador of the United States already addressed to me that she liked these three words, particularly like the word harmony. I said, how could you manage to find this word? It's just published, hide it in the magazine, very, very in the corner. She said, you think that I'm just sitting down there? I don't watch you. I have to do my work, you know. That she liked that very much. I very, very, very much appreciate that for this support. I consider this a support, because you really want to help me to guide my action in the future. So the vision was clearly delivered by membership at the Plenary Presidential Conference in Busan at the end of last year, in particular through the six strategic and financial plans. And now it is up to us to take the action necessary to make that vision a reality. So I'm confident that we will do together to reach the goal, of course, in harmony. And it is an incredible honor for me to lead the union forwards, and you can count on me to live up to your expectations. So distinguished colleagues, as we move forward into a new mandate for ITU, over the next 4 years, we face significant challenges, of course, also opportunities. The challenges which include connecting those not connected yet, encouraging investment for telecommunication ICTs, to help our industries sustainable in their business in a more sustainable environment. We also see, of course, incredible opportunities ahead, both in ITU itself and across the wider ICT sector, which continues to evolve and diversity at tremendous speed in the 21st century. I'm very confident that ITU will be able to continue meeting the challenges ahead, as well as embracing the new opportunities delivered by the changing ICT marketplace, backed by the deep knowledge and expertise of ITU staff and membership, and our proven ability over 150 years to adapt, reform, and innovate to stay in tune with market demands. So ladies and gentlemen, before giving you some more information about the outcome of PP14, I would like to take this opportunity to introduce the new members of the new management team. The first, I start with my Deputy Secretary General, Mr. Malcolm Johnson. I think that all of you know him very well because he was the Director of Standardization Bureau in the last 8 years. But there is one thing you might know, that it was him who kicked me out 8 years ago when I was Director of Standardization Bureau. He said he liked that seat, so he kicked me out. Now, last 8 years, I was Deputy Secretary General. Then he said he liked to have that post again, so kicked me out again. So this is a man very dangerous to me. So I said to be careful, you know, that the doctor kicked me out too quickly. And he was very successful in managing TSB director over the last 8 years. Now, I think that according to ITU protocols, I'd like to introduce my colleague, Mr. François Rancy from France. He's from UK. He's from France. I think I also, you know him very well. He was director of Radio Communication Bureau for the last 4 years. He has done a wonderful job in the past, so that he was not challenged by anybody during the campaign period. And during the election, he was easily elected. So he will take a second term from this year. And he was unlucky. He has to run 4 rounds last time. But anyway, he successfully managed to survive. So next, I'd like to introduce you to my colleague, Mr. Brahim Masanu from Burkina Faso. And he was the director of standardization, not the standardization bureau. It's not my hobby for standardization. He was the director of telecom development bureau for the last 4 years. And also he has done a wonderful job, and people appreciated him and his job very much, so that he was easily re-elected at the last PP14, and he will take a second term from this year. Last, of course not least, is newcomer, last born manager of our member of the management team, is Mr. Chesap Lee from Republic of Korea. And he's not very strange to us because he has been in ITU, in Geneva, in ITU for the last 20 years. And he was an expert from Korea. And he's well known to the standardization world. So welcome you to join us. So after my speech, each of my colleagues will give their own speech to you. So I don't want to take too much time to introduce them further. So distinguished colleagues, let me now turn to the most important event that has happened since the last ambassador meeting here in Geneva, which of course was the 2014 Plenary Potential Conference in Busan in the Republic of Korea. The conference took place in Busan from 20 October to 7th November. And it went very, very well indeed. With record attendance, we were honored by for the first time by the presence of two presidents, president of Korea, the host country president, and the president of Rwanda, as well as 76 ministers, 36 deputy ministers, and many ambassadors. I think that is 56 ambassadors. PP14 was a great success, both for membership and for the union. The conference dealt with 452 proposals from members and created 19 new resolutions while amending 51. For the first time since 1992, there was no amendments were made to the ITU Constitution and ITU Convention. And also, it's the first time in the recent history, or over the last two decades, there was no vote for any resolution, any decision, including those very sensitive issues. We used to have vote in the past, up to last time, 2010. This time, we managed to adopt those resolutions without vote. So we are very pleased with that one. Of course, we appreciate very much your contribution, your support. And I think that this is something we really keep this as a historic event in ITU history. The strategic plan for 2016 to 2019 was backed by the Connect 2020 agenda, which has specific goals and targets for the global ICT sector. The financial plan was approved with a request to balance 13 million Swiss francs over the next 4 years. That management have to work hard to find ways to cover this gap. The final act was signed by 150 countries. It's just on site. It's coincided with our 150th history. And we celebrate our 150 years this year. PP14 also featured a number of important innovations, including the first ever GemTech Awards for ladies, the Young ICT Policy Leaders Program, and a series of five Connect 2020 roundtables. We were very grateful for all the contributions from members, and we are confident that we will meet the targets set for us. Let me close these remarks by saying once more again how much we appreciate your support and how important this will be during ITU's 150th anniversary year celebration year. This year, we celebrate the 150th anniversary since we were set up 150 years ago. And I would like to thank the founding members for their ongoing commitment and contributions. And you might see that at this slide, it's only 16 members, not 20. There's some history behind. Because over the last 150 years, some countries split. I think that Australia and Hungary split. And Norway and Sweden split. But we also have merged. Seven states merged to form today's Germany. So altogether, at this slide, you see 16 national flags. But in fact, we are very pleased. We are very proud. ITU was founded by 20 European states 150 years ago. So let me say how pleased I am that we have the resulting 16 member states here with us today. The main celebration of 150 will be taking place here in Geneva on Sunday, 17th of May, with the World Telecommunication and Information Security Day happening right in the middle of the 2015 session of ITU Council, which runs from 12th to 20th of May. ITU Circular Letter number 1 of 2015 invites members to submit their candidates for the ITU 150 awards. This year we will not do the normal ITU World Telecom and Information Security Award. In the past, from 2006 up to now, we award individuals, maximum five. But this time we consider this is a unique and very important moment for ITU to see the recognized contributions by individuals. So we are not limited this time for five award individuals. We invite our member states to submit their individuals. And the guidelines, criteria, will be posted on the web very soon. And we also invite our sector members, associates, and academy members to submit their candidate to be recognized by ITU as a distinguished individual for award as a sector award. So that one, you know, the guidelines, the criteria also will be posted on the web very soon. We have deadline. We've set up a deadline of 15th of March. You know that after the deadline, we have to review the candidate and then ask competent bodies to establish a shortlist. Then we have to fix the awardees. So we need some fixed time. So the 15th of March will be set up as a nomination by our members. So this information is the first time we announced. So please take this announcement seriously and invite your capitals to help us to prepare the nominations of individuals. And we also try to organize a very special session of celebrations in France, in Paris, because we noted that in Paris, the palace where the historical document signed 150 years ago, still there, still open for their public functions. So we discussed with the French authorities to see if we can organize a special session of a celebration in Paris at the same historic place where the document was signed, and the document was still there, I heard. So that we are talking with French authorities to prepare this celebration. The date has not been fixed because we are waiting for the French authority to have dignitaries be available to our meeting. So the date most probably will be in April, but as soon as the date announced, we will inform you. So we would like to invite you to join us at that celebration as well. So of course, we invite all the members to help us to organize a celebration at their country. And we would like to also find a way to connect those celebrations with our main celebration here in Geneva. So all the way through this year, we will be focusing on different ICT-related themes each month. And we strongly encourage ITU members to associate their ITU 150 activities to themes of a particular interest of each month. And please see the website for further details. Contributions from partners will help to support various global activities related to 150th anniversary, engaging members and promoting the unit. I would like, therefore, to highlight a contribution from all our gold partners. They already committed themselves as gold partners. Azerbaijan, Saudi Arabia, and the United Arab Emirates. We also have silver partners already committed, Ghana, Zimbabwe. And the bronze partners, Central African Republic, NRTB, Huawei, Inmarsat, NTT Group, Root and Schwarz, and Rus Telecom. As we appreciate very much their earlier commitment for partners to join us for celebrate our 150th anniversary. I also invite all of you to see some other opportunities to join us as partners or as other sponsors. As well as the 150 events, we also have a busy year ahead of us this year with major ITU events, including the WISIS Forum immediately after ITU Council in May. And the WISIS Forum we organize annually in May in Geneva, together with UNESCO, UNDP, UNCTAD. It's a very important process for us, and people appreciate that very much. And the UN General Assembly still debate on this process, so we'd like to invite you to support us for this continuation of the WISIS process. The Global Symposium for Regulators in Gabon, in June. ITU Telecom World 2015 will be hosted by Hungary in October, first half of October. And then the year's biggest event, the World Radio Communication Conference, WRC 15, running through the whole month of November, will be held in Geneva. And also, and we will have WITIS, the World Telecom Index Conference, be hosted by Japan in December this year. And through the year, and we will also launch a campaign for small, medium-sized entrepreneurs. And I think that this is a good opportunity for us to see the SMEs who made a lot of contribution to the national economy could be also invited by international organizations like ITU to provide them good opportunities to networking and to form partnership and to attract new investment. So that we like to also focus on these SMEs throughout this year. So we will have further information offered to you very soon. So throughout the year, we will be counting on your continued support in addressing the challenges and seizing the opportunities ahead of us. As you know, I'm personally committed to strengthening cooperation with the membership and with partners, and to increasing transparency, it's quite important for us, and efficiency within ITU. Together, I'm confident that we can connect the world with a better telecommunication and ICT services and deliver a better life to all the world's people. And let me invite you to continue supporting us in this endeavor.